What is your take about this narrative of controlling the foreign trips? And as we go into that, maybe you can clarify budget ya MCAs ya foreign trips ni kiasi gani? Mheshimiwa Lesonet anasema ni 700 million.
Mheshimiwa Lesonet is talking pure lies. Very pure lies. The budget for Baringo County Assembly is not even 700 million. It is 689. That is as per the ceiling.
That's the entire budget.
The entire budget of the county assembly.
To cater for salaries.
Salaries, in allowances, the fuel, the office stationery. We have the electricity bill, the water bill.
So how much goes to trips, in fact, both local and foreign?
In fact, the last, because I'm a budget member also, we use around 9 million to 12 million for foreign trips. And it is their right. Honestly speaking, it is the right of MCAs. We have to do what is called benchmarking. We do benchmarking. You don't expect a leader to be as equal as a village man in the village. Who will teach the other one? Kiongozi akiwa ana hiyo ujuzi ama hajawahi ona hiyo kitu. Tutakuja public participation, tuseme tunataka weka pesa kwa milk plant. Tunataka weka pesa kwa kitu fulani. So, na kiongozi mwenyewe ana idea.
So these trips are for purposes of capacity building.
Capacity
well,
building.
Kama wewe kama majority leader,
yeah.
How many trips have you got?
Asante sana bwana SK, na uliponita interview, and na squeeze nimekasirika sana. I always walk with my passport. Because Mheshimiwa Lesonet has anajaribu kuweka propaganda mpaka kwa kijijini kule naanza kuitwa balozi. Atilau yametembea Tanzania mpaka askari wa traffic wakamuuliza, wewe unafanya kazi gani? Wewe ni balozi ya Kenya kule Tanzania? That's a pure lie.
Sasa umetembea ngapi?
I've traveled to Arusha for only two times. That is,
and in total how many trips have you?
I've gone on for only four trips. Only
four
foreign trips. Foreign trips means going overseas. This for Tanzania is called a regional trip. So I've managed to go to Tanzania twice, Singapore once, and Greece, the recent trip once.
Why did you go to Tanzania before you show us evidence?
Tanzania, we went there to benchmark story of tourism. Wakati ya mambo ya COVID, tukakuta kwamba Tanzania inaendelea na tourism. And they are still fetching a lot of money from the tourism sector. I hope you heard Suluhu saying, you know, when this COVID issue started, Tanzania never...
They never closed their country.
And tourists were going there, so we wanted to see how do they...
And what did you bring to Baringo that has changed? Did you manage to bring anything?
In fact, change haikuanga safari moja bwana SK. Change huwa ifanyike safari moja. So kubwa ya Baringo inakuanga tourism. Na sasa wakati sisi tulipofunga mambo ya tourism hapa Baringo, tulipofunga mambo ya mahoteli manini ya COVID, revenue ikashuka from 350 million mpaka 150 million.
Yeah.
So we have really lost a lot.
So you have to look for ways of... Singapore, what was the purpose of the trip?
The trip of Singapore is that we are very much away kwa mambo ya history ya kwamba Singapore ilikuwa ina loan Kenya by 1960. Kenya ilikuwa ina loan Singapore wakati Kenya ilipata independence. Singapore ilipata independence nyuma ya Kenya. And as we talk about SK, Singapore imegrow kabisa. So we wanted to go and benchmark, how do they make their money?
This is the thing.
Yeah.
2013-2017.
Yeah.
I can remember clearly even our governor then.
Yeah.
Alienda Singapore with some MCAs.
Yeah.
Nyinyi pia mukaenda with some MCAs. Where is the value? Kuna huyu MCA alienda na governor, na huyo governor pia akaondoka. Wewe sasa umeenda, ukaondoka. When will the people of Baringo get to benefit from the capacity that you're going to collect there? That is something that I'm sure it is of concern to anybody who is watching this show. Yeah.
But anyway, I can see now you are also dragging me to the issue of the trip. you are dragging me to the trip. I just want to say this, but SK. And it is good to elaborate.
Well,
I've gone to Tanzania twice. It's good to see, madam.
You can use that camera to show.
I've gone to Tanzania twice.
Onesha your camera, Mheshimiwa.
Can see here. I've gone to Tanzania. Tanzania, that was on 25th November 2019. And 2021, 29th July.
Are you able to get it clearly?
Are you getting it? Unayona? Aya. After Tanzania... This is the one for Athena. This is the one for Greece.
That is the one you're saying you're very proud.
Yeah, I'm proud of it because what I learned in Greece is what I'm now preaching to my people nikiwa kwa kule ground. Greece ni nchi imekauka sana, but they are very rich. Because they have capitalized on on making wine. Mm-hmm. They grow a lot of grapes. Mm-hmm. They make wine and mm-hmm. they make money.
And
they
those get, are very they, serious ideas. And, yeah. And that is the reason why I was asking you, Mheshimiwa. Yeah. Chukulia ni kama I'm dragging you there.
We want to implement
that.
You
know, I'm also a resident of Baringo.
Yeah.
The fact that I'm leading this conversation doesn't mean that I'm a lesser or I should be very neutral. I should not be concerned about issues that are happening in my county. My concern is about the future, for example. You are an MCA now. The value or the knowledge that you've gotten from ile knowledge in Yumepata Pale Greece, how fast? There's something you want to show before we continue?
I'm tracing the one for Singapore, but I went there in 2019. I've only managed 4 trips.
Mm-hmm.
I wanted to come there, and since time is not that.
Darudi hapo, tutamaliza sahi. We only have 3 minutes to go.
Yeah.
What I'm trying to understand is, easy trips, MCAs wakienda, I'll be an MCA today,
yeah.
Then I get voted out. What can we do as a county to ensure that the knowledge that I bring home is documented and is implemented?
Bwana SK,
we ukienda Greece, for example, do you document what?
Yeah, we have a report.
There's a report.
There is no single trip that is done without a report.
Now, as a majority leader,
can
you commit to the people of Baringo kwamba watu wakitembea, the MCAs, the governor, the executive, wakienda, wakuje na hii report, na hii report is a lale, ika collect dust. It to be implemented or ideas to be pulled, ndio isaidie watu.
Unajua Bwana SK, these trips, kama sahi, for the recent one, ile nimeenda Greece.
Mm-hmm.
So nasikia nimekuambia mambo ya industrialization.
Mm-hmm.
How you can make your own factory kwa village.
Mm-hmm.
Unde wine, utumie fruits, vitu kama hizo.
Mm-hmm.
You will have that mind, ukiwa kwa village,
mm-hmm.
you will have that mind, usahili unallocate pesa.
Uh-huh.
Uwezi kubali kuweka pesa, word fund, ile vitu unajua sio viable.
Mm-hmm.
We also saw a lot of fruit canning in many factories.
Mm-hmm.
In Greece, they grew a lot of oranges. And they pack their fruits and export them.
Brilliant ideas.
Yeah. So vitu kama hizo,
mm-hmm.
kiongozi akiwa informed.
Mm-hmm.
Hakuna kitu mzuri kama saa zile kiongozi yako informed.
So in your opinion,
na mtu asikuwe jealous.
Uh-huh.
Because you cannot be a blind leader.
Mm-hmm.
Who lead blind, silent, you will not be blind.
All of you are leading each other.
It's good moja akuwa amekuwa exposed.
Mm-hmm.
My point is this.
Uh-huh.
Mheshimiwa Lesonet,
mm-hmm.
is preaching water and drinking wine. Mheshimiwa Lesonet mwenyewe, we are informed from our own investigation.
Uh-huh.
He has gone for 78 foreign trips.
Tutamleta hapa, pia ajitete.
Get it from me, if you go to his wall.
Wewe umeleta proof kwamba, umeenda zako.
Make sure Bwana SK, once he come here,
uh-huh.
he must come with his passport.
Akuje na passport.
Yeah, because we went, wakati alipongea mambo, tukaenda wall yake ya Facebook.
Uh-huh.
Na tukapata trips kama tano.
Uh-huh.
Ila amesema nimeenda Philippines, mm-hmm. nimeenda wapi. The recent one, ile nilione ya mwisho ya 2016,
uh-huh.
alienda Nigeria. Mm-hmm. Na mimi nataka akuja akanusha hapa mwenyewe.
Mm-hmm.
So I was wondering, what can somebody go and benchmark in Nigeria?
Uh-huh.
Because what we know in Nigeria is just mambo ya majuju na kila kitu. So we also want him to come clear,
uh-huh.
asitumie populist vote.
Uh-huh.
Unajua kuna ile populist vote ya kusulubisha wengine,
uh-huh.
alafu uonekane clean.
Uh-huh.
I'm telling you Bwana SK, Mheshimiwa Lesonet, aliclean chikiti yake,
uh-huh.
kwa kupitia fitina.
Uh-huh.
If I can remember very well, uh-huh. I think nilipokuwa nafanya introduction yangu, I told you ya kwamba,
uh-huh.
I was working with the office of Mheshimiwa Sirma.
Uh-huh.
Na nilipokuwa nafanya kwa office ya Mheshimiwa Sirma, uh-huh. Lesonet came to power kwa kutumia propaganda peke yake. Huyu mtu ameiba, amefanya nini? And that's how he has sustained, is it? And I'm telling every times, I'm sustained kwa kutumia tu propaganda, amefanya, ameinsighti, amefanya hivi.
Well,
but anyway, we don't have any, those are the past.
We may not discuss much about him.
I think
it was clear, it was purely around the conversation on controlling foreign trips.
But for this as the majority leader,
mm-hmm.
I will not allow him to come and demonize the assembly.
Mm-hmm.
The assembly are doing their good work.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, Baringo County recently was ranked number 3,
mm-hmm.
national wide.
Mm-hmm.
Kwamba it is a county assembly yenye inafanya kazi yake kulingana.
Mm-hmm.
We were number 3. So somebody should not come and demonize the assembly in the process ya kutafuta votes, because unajua raia wetu,
mm-hmm.
wanaweza penda sana that narrative ya kusema ai wete all you know you. So I must come out clearly and defend my fellow MCAs.
Mm-hmm.
Ukisikia kazi kama yanakuambia Bwana SK, sisi kama MCAs Aravin tumenunua machines,
mm-hmm.
unafikiri kwa hiyo miaka 15 Lesonet angeshika CDF yake na consolidate,
mm-hmm.
na kununua machines kama ya manda kwa ya lami, tungekuwa na lami ngapi Eldama Aravin?